of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, مَا كَانَ مُحَمَّدٌ أَبَى أَحَدٍ مِّن رِجَالِكُمْ, that regarding Sayyiduna Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he is not one of the fathers of your men. Meaning, in that time, in pagan Arabia, they said the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has no sons who lived. They passed away. So the Arabs found this, the non-Muslim Arabs found this to be a fault. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala corrects them. مَا كَانَ مُحَمَّدٌ أَبَى أَحَدٍ مِّن رَجَالِكُمْ, that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not the father of anyone, مِن رِجَالِكُمْ, of any one of your men. وَلَكِنْ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ, however, he is the Messenger of Allah. وَخَاتَمَ النَّبِيِّينَ, and the finality of prophets. What does this finality of prophets entail? It means that no prophet shall be born after the time of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Therefore, Sayyiduna Isa alayhi salam descending in the end of times does not mean a new prophet has come, because Sayyiduna Isa alayhi salam was born prior to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This verse, Khatam al-Nabiyyin, means seal of prophets. In a qira'ah recitation, it is Khatim al-Nabiyyin. Khatim means the one who seals, the one who does the sealing. Now, the Qadyani movement, Qadyaniya, they claim that Khatim, the one who seals, Mirza Ghulam Ahmad was one of those who was sealed by the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is a misinterpretation of the verse. Unfortunately, that public speaker also used this as a proof, an evidence, making the people, placing this obscurity in front of the people without answering. In public, if a scholar mentions an obscurity, a doubt, he should always mention the response to that obscurity. So, Khatim al-Nabiyyin, meaning the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is the one who seals, does not do away with the other recitation, Khatim al-Nabiyyin, that he is also the one, the seal itself, meaning he seals prophethood, and after him no prophet shall be born. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam foretold in a hadith. This hadith, narrated by Al-Imam Abu Dawud and Al-Imam Al-Tirmidhi and Ibn Hibban in his Sahih, that the Messenger of Allah, and in the Sahih of Al-Imam Muslim also, on the authority of Thawban radiallahu anhu, he said alayhi salatu wasalam, سَيَكُونُ فِي أُمَّتِ كَذَّابُونَ ثَلَاثُونَ, there shall be in my nation 30 liars. ثَلَاثُونَ, 30 liars. كُلُّهُمْ يَزْعُمُ أَنَّهُ نَبِيٌّ, each one of them will claim that he is a prophet. وَأَنَا خَاتُمُ النَّبِيِّينَ, I am the finality of prophets. La نَبِيَّ بَعْدِي, there is no prophet after me. La نَبِيَّ بَعْدِي is a famous hadith, mutawatir. So we have the authority of the Quran, a decisive verse of the Quran, which tells us regarding the finality of prophethood. We have a decisive hadith of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This same hadith, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, this hadith narrated by Al-Imam Ahmad and Abu Ya'la in his Musnad, بَيْنَ يَدَيِّ سَاعَةِ ثَلَاثُونَ دَجَّالًا كَذَّابًا, before the hour, meaning before the day of judgment is established, there shall be 30 liars. Dajjal means what? Those who deceive others. They will be people who deceive. Now,